Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands. Carl felt that it was mission accomplished, with the wicked nectar in his hands.
Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles.
Oh, quand on cherche, on trouve. Parce que je t'aime bien, Aster, je vais te dire quelque chose. Tu fais bien de prendre ma pélisse. Parce que par là-bas, tu vas rencontrer le vrai froid. Un froid qui glace comme t'en as jamais connu dans ta vie.
This oddball mechanic. Surely he would find something somewhere on this land. Luckily, he had the coat to protect him from the biting cold. The cold seemed to be more brutal here than anywhere else. It seeped into bones and into every breath to get to the heart until it stopped. Carl needed to be dressed in warm clothes to survive. Another instance of this magic ice. What was this one doing, lying on the ground, so afraid? The plot thickened like water into ice. He had been running in fear from something creeping towards him, against which he couldn't do anything, only to end up like this, petrified and cold. It seemed as though Regin had been ready to take up arms and slay people like Hamilton. Could he have committed murder for his cause? Who could have gotten killed in front of his very eyes? Carl suddenly felt observed. He was worried about a presence around him. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. No stone can withstand a force of dynamite. Thank you. It was a classic Canadian house, except for the absent horde of kids that would normally be swarming about. The photograph was snapped not too far from here, Carl noticed. The couple seemed to be very good friends. All manners of clothing were gone, as if the Rois drove out of town with their closet in tow.
Thank you.